Good appropriate time of the day to you, friends and enemies. I am Richard, and this whole thing surrounding us is LMTDTMFFR, or, sit with me now, limited time offer, no vowels. And how are you doing today? I am doing well, thank you very much. Today is, it's Tuesday the 23rd, which means that we're a few days into the week, and, we've got over that Monday hump, which is great. I'm glad to see you all survived. It also means, as it's the 23rd, that today is the day that Liberté comes out. The roguelike deck-building type game that was there, that we looked at once way, way back. But yeah, it comes out today, so I would like to look at that at some point. But not now, right now. Right now, he said, seamlessly getting into it, we have the dig, as you can tell by the shovel. But yeah, here we are. And what happened the last time we were here? Well, we opened up this thing, made the alien corpse come to life and talk to it. And then there was, we couldn't understand it because we didn't know their language, so we called up the reporter, Maggie, and said, "Hey, Maggie, can you come and translate what this alien is saying?" And she said, "Yeah, I'll be right there." And then was promptly captured by a spider thing. So yes, looks like we have to go and rescue her. Let's find Brink, even, and call him and say, "Hey." Actually, I don't know if we get anything if we call Maggie. Probably just she's not answering.
"Maggie, come in. Come
Let's
in, Maggie.
Out.
Where are you? I hope I can find her in time."
Oh, here we go.
"Brink, come in, Brink." "Great.
Nobody's answering.
To play hide and seek."
All right. Well, we know where
well,
he
I don't
is.
Have time to waste on children's games.
All right. Well, we know where he is. Oh, I didn't need to do that. I can just click exit. So let's go find him. It's this way. I want you to exit. Is there no exit thing over here? It's not blue. Oh, we have to keep going. Ah, yes. The site of our dead guards. What happens if you try and revive the guards? Have you got a line for that?
"Yeah, right. Like I want to revive them now, when they'd be really mad.
They'd be dead and crushed under the rocks. But it's just the way it would go. Onwards. And up on this lift that we... Yeah. There we go, and there's that rock. I don't know how you're meant to work out that you use that
it's
rod
jammed.
On the rock. You just do.
"I can't get it out.
I don't know why we need the lights either, but apparently we've got these lights. Maybe that turns on the ability to open the shutter? Oh, just go outside. If they had shown that over here, then maybe we would have a chance of knowing. Right, we haven't been to the fifth place, wherever that is. Haven't made it there yet. The fifth spire. Aha! And here is Brink. Yep, working away. Let's go see him and talk to him, eh? Answer your goddamn phone, Brink. I need your help.
"What are you doing here, Lo? I don't want you here."
"I don't care."
"Something happened to Maggie. She needs our help."
"Then go help her." "What
she
I'm doing here is
important. Our help, both of
hey,
us."
"Hey, if we felt that way about you, you'd still be dead."
"You're the tough guy, Lo. You're the hero."
"Eh."
"Go do your hero activities and let me do the science."
No. Oh, crystal stash.
What do you think you're doing?
I was looking. We gotta wait for you to walk all the way back over here so we can have the conversation.
I appreciate your apparent concern. Really, I'm fine. But please, feel free to leave.
Alright, there's the cursor come back, finally.
What are you doing with all these life crystals?
Consuming them.
I told you to go away. There's nothing here that you're capable of understanding.
Where's this relic? We don't know.
What kind of contraption has Brink made here?
We don't know. What about you? Can you tell me, Brink? Oh, you're gonna have to walk over here, are you? So that we can have the conversation. Can't just happen anywhere.
Brink.
Yeah, Monster.
Maggie's in trouble.
Then go help her.
Maggie's in trouble.
I'm sorry to hear of this. I will miss Maggie a great deal.
She can come back.
Brink, there's a dead alien sealed inside a crystal tomb.
In a culture that can raise the dead, they probably have a good reason when they choose to bury somebody instead of reviving
them. We had that.
Now leave me alone.
We had that before. Hey, I found an opening.
A passage under that tomb I found.
I mean, I don't know that I
told
you about the tomb.
Something important down there.
Yeah, it's the dead alien. You haven't seen any more of those, have you?
I found a bunch of these metal plates.
Because I am missing a metal plate.
When we've got them all, maybe we can
go home. Tunnel.
You remember home, don't you, Brink? Earth, family, friends, food.
You're doing very well, Commander Lo. By all means, go find the rest of the metal plates. Go quickly. Go now.
Yep. Always a pleasure to hear that. All right, well, we'll stop talking to you. Well, actually, let's say something
profound. Get your priorities straight. We're talking about Maggie's life here.
Well, there we go.
What do you know about life? And if she's killed, so what? We just bring her back better than ever.
I mean, he makes a valid point for the idea that
Maggie?
These crystals are conquering
you go
death.
Look for her, I stay here and work.
All right. Well, then.
Never mind.
Away we go. Out onto the light bridge. Where's the map? There's the map, swear. Let's go to the map room. See. Was Maggie in here? She was in a room with lots of crystals. No, this is not the right place. Let's see if we can see where Maggie is. Just go round and round. I don't know if we can get a view of where Maggie is. That's the tomb, okay. Now we know about that.
So there is more to that crypt than I first thought.
I mean, you found the alien beneath it, so yes. That's the one we just did. Green, blue, green, and red. Okay. Green. Blue. Green, red. Well, I can't remember if it was triangles or diamonds. Not triangles. I mean cubes or diamonds. But that's not the place either. I mean, you would have thought they would have made this quicker. I mean, you can dial. We might have, you know, like 1 to 9 dials on things. Hex squidge, diamond squidge. Hex squidge, diamond squidge. Hex. Squidge. Diamond. Squidge. No. Alright, well, maybe Maggie doesn't show up on the map. I mean, we've got one more. Triangle, triangle, squidge, hexagon. Stupid me. Triangle, triangle, squid checks. Red. Blue. Nope, okay. You're not showing me anything. Oh well. Let's go down this opening. Alright, this is where we came from. Okay, let's go out this to the pit. No, she doesn't appear to be in here. Let's go to the chamber. Let's go to the ledge. Is it in the opening? No, this is down here. Alright. Well, no, we're in here. Okay, let's go back to the light bridge, because that's quicker than the tram, and we know she's not in the central area. Is there anything around here? I've got a feeling I've missed one of the four plates, and I should have been able to find the other area that the other place. Oh, I might be wrong about that. I know eventually we'll find it. Right, we get the map. Let's do the tomb. No, this is where we came from. Yep, okay. Thank you. This is back to the tomb. Anything over here? No, not then, sorry, spy base. That's back to the tram, and there's nowhere to go around here, so back up we go! Plateau path, light bridge. Okay, so we've done map, we've done tomb. Let's go to the planetarium. I don't think it is. Pretty sure we've, yeah. I don't think there's anywhere in the cave that you can exit. Nope. Ah, it's our elaborate thing. And that's just a door to nowhere. Do that and then just come out again, it's quicker. Is it this way? No, this is just where there's a crevice. Alright, well, you better be in the last place, otherwise I know I've missed something, and maybe we'll have to look at a guide. No, wait, light bridge, that one. Museum spire. Ah. No, I don't think you're in the museum either. Because I know you're not here, and there wasn't an exit from here. Oh, a door. Oh! This is where Maggie was.
This looks like the place Maggie was when she was abducted.
I don't know how you know she was there.
Those must be the consoles she was using to learn the language.
Alright, well, look at the console. They're looking to walk through. There are four locations.
If this is a library, then this must be where you search and retrieve data.
Alright. Can we search and retrieve any data?
Control console.
Yeah.
If this is a library, then this must be where you search and retrieve data.
Let's just press random buttons on there until we find a picture of the spider, and then see if it's got something which tells you how to kill the spider.
If this
eh?
Is a library, then this must be where you All search right. and retrieve data.
What about this console?
The screens must be part of one large computer.
Did LucasArts do the... Do the Star Trek games? Alright, well this is where... that's you. Alright, well this is where you were. Cool, good for you. You go enjoy Disneyland. There's absolutely nothing wrong with enjoying Disneyland. So, thanks for stopping in. Enjoy your sleep. Alright, so if that's where she was taken from, where has she been taken to? Nexus Museum, Planetarium, Maps. Right, there's four. That's four. There's another one, though. Or is that where... down here by the water. I can't even dive into the water. Well, no, I can dive into the water. Alright, well, let's go for a swim just for the hell of it. Just cool and relaxing, eh? Apparently we have an escalator land today. I'm just talking to anyone who gets that reference, especially if they ask when do we get to the right. Nope. I'm afraid I do not get the reference. Alright, well maybe we will go back to the Nexus. Simpsons is a good bet. Alright, this is... there was no way to open that door. Ah, Fairly Odd Parents. That, yeah. That does seem like a thing that should have... maybe not should have remembered. I haven't seen as much of that as I would want to. It was a very funny series. Onto the tram, onto the tram. You have seen none of that series. Well, I don't know that I'd say you are missing out, but you know, it was pretty good. You're not down this dark tunnel, are you? No, because this is where... kept going past anything reasonable. I mean, it's kind of how it went. Where have you been captured, Maggie? I really feel... maybe I don't need to get through that door. I mean, there was a reason why it kept going and going and going, an in-universe reason, which, you know, I thought was reasonably smart of them to have a reason for it. Okay, we've done a complete circuit. I have no idea. I have no idea where Magega is. You're not here. Why would they have brought you outside of the place? I don't know, actually. Maybe you're at the grave. Maybe it's not a grave. Maybe it's a place where the spider brings all of their bones. Nope, doesn't look right. So... not down here. Because that would be silly. Oh, have you got something to say about the empty slot?
It's the slot where I found the blue crystal.
Yeah, it is. Let's go back to the museum again, because that is where Magagagagi last was. Wait, this way, right? Well, it doesn't matter. I can just pick any one of those wires and then go to the light bridge. So, yeah. They turned us all into the pets. I don't know that I am wanting the four plates right now. Maybe I am, but yes, it is. That is the thing. What I'm looking for is to rescue Maggie. Right, okay, you're saying that there was one in the Nexus, one in the museum, one in the planetarium, and one in the map. Because, yeah, I might have missed one. Who knows which one? Crevice. No, this is the crevice place. There's no... I don't know if I need the next plate in order to open up and rescue Magagagagi. I can't remember. Let's just check that I'm not carrying it with me, because I'm not that dumb. Nope, definitely not that dumb. That's good to know. That's gonna take me back to where I came from, right? Yep, yeah, cool. That's not the cave. Crack. I've seen that crack before.
I can see outside.
Yes, you can. That's great. Good for you. So Maggie has been captured by a horrible monster. We need to rescue Maggie. We need to find Maggie. And as far as I know, I don't know if I need to find another place to do it. I cannot recall. Right, I can get to the light bridge. I think I got the one in the right map. Nexus. Planetarium. And museum. Pretty sure I got the one in the museum. Planetarium is the one we just came from. Let's go have another look at the map. Maybe I missed one in the map? Maybe I didn't. I mean, this is where Magagi was. Panel. Panel? Oh, that's the using of the panel. Looks like it's in the map wire if you are right. Alright, well, I'm obviously just missing. Wait. No, what? She is in the map wire if you are right. Okay, well, we're in the map wire. This is the way back to the light bridge, and there's nothing we can do here. We can only go back or use the light bridge. And we've done the light bridge, so let's go back. Then it doesn't appear to be anything. Walk north to the map room, left to the pit, and then go through the doorway to enter the chamber. Okay. Into the doorway to enter the chamber, thank you. Now I'm in the chamber. Did I just not walk far enough over? Is that the... nest! Yeah, there we go. That is one of my big problems with this. With, not this, with point and click games. Unclear exits and not finding things. There we go. Thank you for your generous help. Here we are.
Maggie! Is that you? Are you alright?
Oh.
How could you be alright bound up in that web like that?
Maybe she likes that. Alright, there's our monster. Let's examine the monster.
This guy is big and nasty. Smells pretty bad, too.
What else have we got in this room? A grate.
It looks like a grate sealing something off.
Okay.
It looks like a grate sealing something off. Robbins.
Oh, let's have detailed questions from
Maggie,
you.
Maggie, are you injured?
Not yet, but I'd really like to get out of here before anything worse happens.
The monster seems kind of possessive about it.
Yeah, he definitely likes me. But I don't like him, Boston, and I'd really appreciate it if you'd get me out of here.
I mean, if you say so.
Brink's still running around loose in the
room. Well, maybe you should go find him.
We know where he is.
The way it's going, it might take both of you to get me out of here.
Ah, what a strong hint that is. Oh.
Maggie, about the library.
This is really bad timing, Boston.
Meh.
Get me out of here.
You can't go anywhere, so I can just talk to you about
Maggie,
all this
I'll
thing.
Try to think of something to free you.
Don't take too long. I think that thing likes me.
I thought of something, and I may need your help.
Can we please concentrate on helping me first?
Yeah, that seems like a reasonable thing.
Incidentally,
use your lightsaber. wrong game.
No.
If only I could carry it over between one game
now
and the next.
Get me out of here.
I mean, that was the whole point of gaming NFTs, right? Hey, what happened? If you die, do you want to
so,
be brought back?
What else have you found out about the crystal?
No, not what I was asking.
Distracting me from this predicament while you figure a way to get me out of here.
Yep, that's definitely what I'm doing.
Have you found a way to translate?
Translate this. Get me out of here.
Maggie, about the bridges. What are you?
Can we please discuss that later?
Yeah, I guess
just
so.
Just get me out of here.
You don't want to continue our light bridges, lighthouse discussion.
Maggie, regarding the plates, I have a theory.
Can we please discuss that later? Just get me out of here.
I'm realizing more about these.
No, you're not.
Can you realize my freedom first?
All right, I guess we can realize your freedom, if you insist.
Thanks.
Thanks. Can I attack you?
The monster hasn't eaten Maggie yet.
Let's try. No.
I don't want to be the one to attract his attention.
Ah, okay. So, right, yeah, we need.
Boston, where are you going? I'm over here.
Yeah, but I'm leaving.
Bring help.
Yeah, exactly. I'm gonna go and get Brink. I remember how to get Brink. That is something that I do remember. I need to go to the tram. We'll go back this way. You were in. Where were you? Were you in the tomb's fire? Yes. There you are. Now I need to get your help. Can't you just call up Brink? He won't answer his phone. He's too busy with the machine and the life crystals. Hey, I need your help. I want to talk to you and say Maggie needs our help. I know, well, I mean, I don't know of a way to do it, but I have an idea. I found the monster.
There's got to be a way to get rid of that monster once and for all.
I mean, maybe.
Maggie's in trouble. She's trapped, and we need to save her before she becomes dinner for some hideous creature.
Yeah, come help me.
Sorry to hear of this. I will miss Maggie a great deal.
Oh, well.
Never mind.
All right. Well, we're just going to do the thing that I know how to do. This is the thing that I remember. All right, you. Time to annoy some alien creatures.
Come on, guys. Let's get a look at you.
No! Go away!
Woo! Alright. Now what we do is you do the same thing you would do with any addict, obviously, when you're not trying to help them. You steal their stash. These are mine now.
You thief!
Yeah.
Give those back!
I will, Brink. After you help me find Maggie.
I mean, we found
Maggie.
I'm not
going to waste one moment on such a meaningless task.
Yes, you will, Brink. If you ever want these life crystals back.
You're a miserable bully, Lo. Typical military mind. Pushing other people around.
Right. So follow me and do as you're told. Is that rational enough for you?
Alright, well. Do follow me. Just continue following me. How did you get off the bridge before me? And how do I know you're not just gonna to move the lens? Pit chamber over here. Further along. I mean, what makes you think? Why would I think that I can go further in this direction? Here we are at the nest. Right, well. Let's see if we can distract it with a light.
I don't want to be the one to attract his attention.
Alright, well then.
Brink. Unless we want to end up where Maggie is, we've got to get by this thing.
The obvious plan is for one of us to distract him while the other one slips by.
Maybe you are thinking better, right? You want to sneak or distract?
I'll be the diversion.
You've got your own flashlight.
Come here, you phlegm, carapace, slime-faced, mucus-brained, furry-legged abductor of luminously intelligent but pulchritudinous Earth women.
I didn't understand most of those words. I must come over and talk to you.
No, you idiot! Why are you standing there?
I'm still trying to figure out what you said.
Move your silly buttocks, you fool!
Alright, well, here I am.
Boston, where are you going?
I don't know.
I'm over here.
I didn't click.
Don't leave me.
Well, look at that. We got past. And now we'll just leave them to be eaten. Sound like a good plan? Oh, let's go and have some relaxing time on the beach, eh? Oh, lovely. Oh, and while I'm relaxing like this, I should say, I have added more points rewards to the things. Why not? Wouldn't that be fun? A beach. What does it see here? So now you can compliment You can get a compliment from me. Yes, why not? Just figured I'd add some things in. And, you know, if you don't get one. And you're fairly sure you just saw the t-shirt as well. Yep, probably. Yes, that is the other one. Oh, right. No, that is where I want to go. The full source. Yes, I remember. Do-do-do-do-do-do. If I walk across. Woo! I think I'm going to have to refund your points for that because I'm not really certain how to do.
At this point, I'm ready to try.
I'm not really sure how I can do upside down controller with this, given that I have, you know, no controller. Upside down mouse. I mean, this would not just be upside down mouse because, odds up mouse for camera if can get in view. Down. Yeah, that's very useful. It's a trackable mouse, which I operate with my thumb, my hand going like that. So, you know, I can try that. But I just don't know how different it will be. There we go. I pushed a button that I didn't even mean to push when I was putting my hand into position. And now I can't see because I'm walking. Right, now I'm down here. Okay. Nest. Tries to remember which one I would usually click. Nope, that's the wrong button. There we go.
Who are you? This monster has me trapped.
Well, yeah, I was doing a thing, alright?
Boston? Where have you been?
I've diverted some of the water from the falls. I thought some of it might flow through here and wash the monster away.
Well, instead, the monster's got Brink trapped up there, and I'm still stuck down here.
Slowly, slowly move it over. There we go. Great. Oh, what are you doing, computer? Why did you do that?
I think the water I diverted from the waterfall is flowing right to that grate.
Yeah. Clean the grate. Clean it with your shovel.
It won't accomplish anything.
All right. Here's the tusk, because we haven't used the tusk on anything. So at some point, well, I don't know. Have we used the tusk on anything?
It won't do anything.
All right. Well, we're back to the good old fashioned. Try everything with everything.
It won't accomplish anything.
I mean, it might.
It won't do anything.
I want you to go down there and clean the grate, I guess. Or maybe I want you to block the grate so that the pressure builds up. Maybe I could try putting. I've done a rib cage. Maybe it's as simple as. No, I can't see the monster. No, walk over here. No, don't go out the door. Walk over and check the monster with the flashlight in front of it, and then maybe it will just happen. Can I see the monster? I can't see the monster. Awesome. Alright, attract it. Yeah!
I don't want to be the one to attract his attention.
Can I talk to Brink? Oh! No, I can click outside the screen though and get it all wrong. Brink?
Brink.
Yeah, lower it over in front of that grate.
There's a grate down by Maggie. If you can lure the monster over toward it, then when Maggie unclogs the grate, the water I diverted will hit it like a fire.
Uh-huh. Maggie is going to unclog the grate.
This is seriously your plan?
Do you have a better one?
Maggie, can you get the grate open?
Has anybody thought of the fact that if it does spout water like a fire hose, I'm right here?
Yes.
That's a good point, Maggie.
You're in the web.
Hold on tight.
How do I hold on tight when I'm unclogging a grate?
That's why you get the big bucks.
Do it then. Just do it.
I'm a reporter who is renowned enough to be sent on an away mission on a spacecraft. But now, I'm a plumber.
Come on, you ponderous exoskeleton. You cocoon-eating
lobster-faced
arthropoidal elementary sphincter muscle.
Oh, sphincter muscles. It's not to say that they're not, that plumbers aren't important, but there's a scale of importance where I think spacemen might rank above them. And then Magaggy. A single. Yeah, there we go. And the spider thing obviously can't crawl.
Maggie, you made it.
Huzzah!
You're worried about your...
I was joking, Boston. You know, like you strong, manly types do when you just about get killed.
Maggie's safe now. I satisfied our little deal.
Yep.
So give me my crystals and let me get back to work.
Brink, it's time for us to work together on...
I said give them to me!
Ah!
Take one more step closer, Maggie, and you'll wish you were back with that giant lobster.
Oh no, he's taken all of the crystals.
He sure is weird.
Now what?
I mean, he wasn't.
I've been getting the feeling that the ghosts want us to help them. As if they were stuck and wanted out.
Stuck how?
Well, the library console seemed to indicate that they may have left this world for another. What if they want to come back, but can't?
I don't know. How will we go about helping, assuming that's what they want, and they wouldn't need us when they got back?
Beats me. I'm just interpreting.
Alright, are you following me now, my Magagaggy? Oh, that clicks into place. I was again putting my hand back on the controller. Alright, Robbins.
Robbins.
Good work with that grate.
You handled that whole business with the grate pretty well, Maggie.
I hate to admit it, but it was a good idea you had. Not everybody thinks of diverting a waterfall.
I'm not sure I would have thought of it either. I must have thought of it at one point.
I can't help feeling a little angry.
You know, there wasn't the possibility of looking online to find
out of his mind with greed. He's not himself. It's those damn crystals.
About three quarters of the way
through.
You
were starting to tell me something before Bob the Lobster came to pick you up for your date.
Just a sample of what I was reading. Nothing significant. What mattered is that I could understand it. I've caught on to how their language works.
Yay! Well, then you can come with me and talk to the person.
I don't know about you, but I'm starting to get tired. I've done a lot of digging.
And I've done so much reading, my eyes ache.
And Brink is dead tired.
What do you think of our situation now, Maggie?
You want the truth, Boston?
Yes. Of course I want the truth.
I thought I had faced reality when Brink died. But when that monster carried me off, I finally understood what it means to be in an alien place. Nothing here is going to go the way we expect it. There's no guarantee there even is a way home.
We have had some help from the ghosts.
Help? They have their own ideas of what they want us to do. They don't care whether we get home or not.
But I do, and you do, so we're not giving up.
Oh, I know. I'll keep on searching and trying to understand. Even if I die here, I'll at least know something about the place before I croak, right?
I guess that's a comfort.
Is it? Okay.
You still hanging in there?
I'm okay, Boston. Don't worry about me.
Too late. Tell me about the library.
I still can't believe you were able to decode an alien tongue.
I didn't say I was fluent. And they designed it so foreigners like me could decode it.
Cool.
Do you have any idea what it was you did to attract the thing to you?
I don't wear perfume, and heaven knows this outfit isn't exactly alluring.
Hang in there.
I was just sitting there.
Like webs.
Apparently,
indeed.
That's enough.
That's usually enough for very lonely men on Earth. As for this monster, I'd just as soon not have another date like that anytime soon.
Dead creature. I found
when
a dead creature.
You before you were kidnapped, I was trying to tell you that it worked.
What worked?
I revived the alien.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Was it angry? Glad?
He didn't kill me, if that's what you mean. He talked to me, but I didn't understand anything he said. Maggie, we've got to find a way to communicate with the alien inventor.
I know, Boston. He's the only one who can answer our questions.
He's also the only one who knows for sure how to get us home.
Oh. I mean, that's easy enough.
I never would have found out anything from the map room if there hadn't been all those engraved keys lying around. Almost as if they were left for us.
I was going to say, didn't one of them just
only intelligent beings would have been able to figure out how to use them.
Maggie, that's the sweetest thing you've ever said to me.
I meant any being over the intellectual level of, say, a baboon.
Oh, now you're making me blush.
You.
Where are those ghosts when you really need them?
Yeah.
They only show up when they think they need us.
Have you learned anything about those metal plates?
The shapes are all significant in their written language.
Oh, they okay.
They're also rich with symbolism in their culture.
But you have no clue what they have to do with navigation, right?
That's right. I'm a clue-free zone on that one.
You won't believe what I found, Maggie. The central island and the five rock spires around it aren't just connected by underwater trams. There are also light bridges leading from the spires to this amazingly transparent crystal above the center island.
A bridge made from light?
Aren't most crystals
transparent?
I know,
it doesn't make any sense, but it's true.
Their technology is so far advanced beyond ours that I don't know if anything could surprise me now.
Aha! Is this where we do?
If they can make bridges out of light, yep. You have to wonder if they can make anything else.
And now we can do it on purpose.
You mean light beer?
I was thinking more of a lighthouse.
Yes, lighthouse.
Light summer clothing.
Light-hearted.
Light summer clothing.
Light-fingered.
Light summer clothing.
Light-hearted.
Oh, Boston. You are just stuck on a one-track mind, aren't you? I don't know anything else that could be light.
Can you make any sense out of this?
It didn't even look like the same language to me before. But now I can see the relationship between this writing and the things I read in the library.
What does it say?
It seems to be talking about an important thing, I don't know what, that was hidden.
Any hints about where?
On the other side of the hole, so that none may enter. Then it tells how to, pull back this part of entrance, whatever that means. It's pretty vague.
There are some things that man was not meant to understand.
Yeah, but this one even woman is having a hard time with.
After seeing what they've done to Brink, we'd better think long and hard before we start duplicating these back on Earth.
Don't worry. We're probably never going back there.
I mean, yeah, that's a good
point. And even if we
do,
I doubt anyone will ever be able to figure out this alien science.
I mean, the people who use the crystals seem to be able to do it. All right, okay. Let's go talk to the alien at the top of this place.
Thanks.
Not that door. Then over here. Is Maggie coming with me? She is. She's just being slow about it. And when I get to the tomb, that is when I'm going to stop being upside down. Which will be, you know, approximately 3 of those Earth minutes that you talk about. Which I think is the amount of time that I said. Was it a problem?
Robin.
Kind of? No. I mean, yes, I just clicked on the wrong person, on the wrong thing.
Never mind.
Though there's no guarantee that I wouldn't have done that. Anyway, alright, here we go into the tomb. And I think it would be more of a horrible thing to do, like, in the middle of one of my roguelike things, or, you know, I was going to say X-Men. I meant Star Wars. I don't know why I was thinking X-Men. But yeah. Upside down controller. Oh, you know, there are some roguelikes that I play with a mouse keyboard. No, not up. Out. Oh, is it out this way? It's out this... No? Can we... Where am I going? Is it this way? This doesn't feel right, walking. No. Must be over here. Come on, get me to the creature. So I can turn my mess the right way up. There we go. Hey, Maggie. Look, it's those things. Oh, you know what I should have done? Alright, now we get to the pyramid and this creature. I'm going to realise I don't have any life crystals on me, aren't I? Because Brent took them all. Brink took them all. Right. Yep. No life crystals. Hey, I can do this. Look at the thing I can do. Use the rod with the alien corpse.
Use these two things together.
Put it in his butthole and then leave it there for when you resurrect it. Hey, Maggie. You don't have any life crystals on you, do you?
After seeing what they've done to Brink, we'd better think long and hard.
I didn't want you to ask that question. I wanted you to, you know.
Don't worry. We're probably never going back there. And even if we do, I doubt anyone will ever be able to figure out this alien science.
Alright, well, we know where there were some. So let's stop the conversation.
Thanks.
Go to the walkway. I'm still upside down. Go to the first spire that we were at. Because there was that huge room filled with things. I'm certain they'll be there. Up. Yeah, I don't know that upside down controller is necessarily a huge problem in point and click style games. No, not Robins. Path. Light bridge. Museum. Down. Tram. Door. Life crystals. It's weird having to use my fingers for different things. Let's take 6. I know the picture doesn't go beyond 4. There we go. Some life crystals. Alright, and now, to do the elaborate production of turning my mouse the right way around again. I mean, I guess if I was doing like some intensive thing in a point and click adventure game, I'm not sure if I would class the Sherlock Holmes games as, I mean, there are some point and click parts of it where you're like against a timer and things like that. That would be a problem. That might cause me problems if it was upside down. Yeah, I've remembered that I can press the escape key to skip that bit. Ooh, I could probably use it, do it on most things, you know. Onwards, onwards to the dead creature. Oh, they haven't closed up the pyramid this time. It's just the dead creature. Hey, dead creature. Time for you to talk to Magagagi.
Here's where my alien education either pays off, or we die.
Die?
As long as I don't accidentally offend him, we'll be okay.
Aklash Park.
He says, open your mouth, which is their way of saying, speak.
You do the talking, Maggie, so you can understand each other.
Speak.
Woo! Alright, well, first thing to do is to say something profound.
We want to go home.
That is the wish of all living creatures. It is a vain wish, for there is no true home.
No, I mean, we're not...
All intelligence wanders and has no...
No, we're
rest.
Talking about to our planet, you dickhead.
The probe you sent
Philosophical
out brought us here. We want to go back to our home planet.
Another one of our terrible mistakes. We sent out those probes when we thought we had found the glorious secrets of the universe. We could not call them back. Thus, I remain here to warn all those who come in answer to an invitation we wish we had not sent.
Yeah, you get to see people.
Warning us won't do any good unless we can get back home to Earth to tell other humans.
There are two ways to protect your planet. One is if you return and warn them to stay away. The other is if you never return at all.
Well, that's not
Which
true.
Which warning do you think will be more effective?
Returning and telling them to stay away. Because if we do not turn up, chances are, well, I mean, space is big. But, you know, we'll probably bumble into you by mistake at some point.
Tell us how to get back to Earth.
Exactly.
I beg you.
If my people could return from space-time 6 where they have gone, they would rebuild the starport. They would make a crystal ship which would take you back to your planet. But they will never find their way back home.
Because...
Why was your tomb so carefully hidden?
So only the most persistent, the most clever, and therefore the most dangerous of visitors would find me.
What if we just decided to take over the planet and ignore everything that was
Why
up there?
Why has your body been preserved so carefully?
Since all the evil in this place was my fault, I chose to be its guardian forever.
If what you did was bad, why do the museum displays give you so much honor?
There was a time when my creations were thought to be good. I believed it myself, or I would never have created them.
How long will you remain here?
Until the last of my mistakes is rectified, or until the life crystals lose their power out of miserable death.
I don't know why you need to know about the Great,
There's
but okay.
There's water everywhere in these islands. Waterfalls, pools, and the sea all around.
We love the water. But now my people live in an eternal desert, neither drinking nor thirsting.
Yeah.
If only they could thirst again.
Your people, it's always about your people, isn't it?
If only they could dive into the sea and hear the roaring of the waterfall.
The language of the library was a great achievement. It was so clear and surprisingly easy to learn.
The greater the idea, the simpler and clearer the language needed to express it.
Yep, that is true.
The creatures who live here now, did you people know of them, or did they come later?
Millions of years have passed since then.
Jeez, millions of years.
What once were pets or companions have followed their own evolutionary paths.
Why couldn't they have grown up to be sentient, sapient intelligences like you?
As stupid as it was in them to be.
The monster who captured me. Are there any more of them?
That one did not evolve. It was made.
Huh? The Guardian?
And there are as many of them as are needed.
Well, that isn't good. Tell me about yourself.
Who
I mean,
are you, Honored One?
We should have said our names
the
in the beginning.
Of misfortune.
You know?
Please, tell me who you are.
I am the doer who undoes. The creator who uncreates. And yet, I would gladly be the destroyer who undestroys. The dangerous one. Who protects?
I am the bringer of destruction for those who are immortal. I am the one who walks where others ride. They call me Kevin.
Speak plainly. Tell us who you are.
Once I was hailed as the greatest mind my people ever produced. I tried to bring them power and happiness. I gave them power to leave this world, to leave their bodies, to enter an existence as pure mind, eternally perfect. But I could not give them the power to return and reclaim their abandoned bodies, their decaying world.
And everybody agreed
they
to it?
They lost.
All at the same
and
time?
Cannot return.
I mean, wow, that's an achievement among... That's an achievement to get everybody to agree to do the same thing.
Have you a name?
I had a name when I was alive. Now that I am again and again dead, what need have I for names?
So people can speak
my
to you.
My body
and say
is now
stuff.
So ancient that the crystals scarcely have power over me. I rise for a few minutes, and then I fall again. Soon I will cease to rise at all.
I mean, that's not true.
Only then will my grief end. I want no name or memory to live after me.
You don't want to be a warning to other people? Alright, fine. I mean, that's not true. I could sit on this screen for a year if I wanted to without pressing the stop talking button, and you would still be animate. Ha. Ah.
The map helped us find you. Did you create it?
It was created by those who now wish only to find themselves.
You are...
Why is this inscription in another kind of writing?
I did not write it. I would not have written it.
I can read it, but the meaning isn't clear. It speaks of something hidden.
It was the first achievement on the road to my greatest error. The one that condemned my people.
The light bridges are magnificent. We never dreamed that people could walk on light.
Yes, we
yes.
did.
We were happily surprised
we dreamed of
how
it.
Convenient
we just
those
lifespans
turned out to be. If we had known, we would not have bothered to build the trams.
If you were surprised that the lights could be used as bridges, what did you create them for?
When all the bridges are complete, the eye will see.
You're good.
When you say the eye will see, you aren't talking about our eyes, are you?
An eye that can see the three dimensions of time, as well as the three dimensions of space. It will show you beauty beyond belief. But once you have seen space-time 6, will you ever see space-time 4 again? The eye may be open, but the mind hasn't the strength to see.
When you say space-time 6 and 4, are you talking about dimensions? I don't know. Also, notice how this is in the... how most of that text covered, you know, everything that was going on the screen. Somehow they hadn't perfected subtitles moving from, you know, advancing as people were speaking.
The metal plates we found, what are they?
They are authority and power. Each shape has a meaning. And when they are fitted together, they have a new meaning.
If we put the control plates in the triangle, what will happen?
You will open the door to beauty without boundaries, and to trouble without end.
Nah.
What are the ghosts we saw? Are they alive?
My people all traveled to the realm of space-time 6, where three dimensions of time join to the three dimensions of space.
That'd make
it
things
is indescribably beautiful, but they can build nothing there. They can create nothing. They just exist, on and on with empty lives and hearts that long for this hard and stony world.
Surely they can conceive of things and be invent ideas, men? Ideas? Inventor? Well, whatever. Right, they can't physically build a thing. But maybe they can
do something
else.
The ghosts are your people, then.
Their connection to this world is so slight. They can disturb the energy in the air. They can make themselves visible for a few moments.
How often?
But they can't build anything here. They will live forever. But it is not life.
I mean, they did build a thing. They made that key appear out of nowhere, because it wasn't there before.
Is it impossible for your people to come back?
It takes enormous strength of will to leave that place and come back to this one. They have all tried. They have all failed. And now they have been away too long. They have lost the physical memory of how to live here in space-time 4.
Why did the ghost lead us to you?
Some of them foolishly hope that if I help you open the gateway again, you might have the strength to lead them home, to let them remake their bodies here. But I am sure that all that would happen is you, too, would be lost in space-time 6.
We're humans. We're gonna do it.
Did you invent the life crystals? To raise the dead is the greatest achievement we've seen.
What raises the dead can debase the living.
Yeah, was that a yes or no?
What the crystals create is not a life, but a slave.
Well, if that's true, then how are you not slavering and attacking us with the crystals we have?
So when the life crystals restore you, you aren't really alive?
They restore the cells and the organs, but take away all that made the life worth living.
Then why did you make them?
Our society became obsessed with living eternally. I underestimated the breadth and danger of the obsession. The crystals are the second worst mistake I made.
And the first is space-time 6. I mean, I don't quite understand how, if everybody's obsessed with the crystals, why did they go into space-time 6?
Thank you for helping us.
I mean, did you?
I will only have helped you when you give up your foolish plan.
We're not giving up.
My only consolation is that true death comes closer with each dying.
Bye-bye. Blah.
Good job of translating, Maggie.
He speaks very slowly and clearly. But I'm also pretty damn good.
There you are. All right, well... we still need to find the other plate. Let's go and see Brink. I believe Brink is doing something at this point that we want to see. Tries desperately to remember exactly what is going on. I mean, I could, I suppose, try. No, he's not anywhere near the things anymore, so I can't get them to attack him anymore. Are you coming, Maggie? Hello, Brink. How you doing? You're not looking so hot.
Brink. Brink, there's a dead alien sealed inside a crystal tomb.
In a culture that can raise the dead, they probably have a good reason when they choose to bury somebody instead of reviving him.
Yeah, well, that's
now, leave
not...
me alone.
No, I wanted to know more about...
There are side effects to the life crystals, Brink. They change your personality. They seem to be making you crazy.
Yes, the poor, ignorant fools who slog through the mud of inferior mental functions. They look at brilliance and call it madness.
Yep. You sure do.
Thanks for helping me save Maggie.
You've already rewarded me by being a pushover, Commander.
You know anything?
About the...
I don't have time to waste on foolish discussion of nothing.
Alright, okay. Well,
why
then.
Do I bother? Talking to you is a waste of time.
No. I mean, alright. Down. Alright, well. I mean, can we go to the library? Can you... like, do anything at the library in the map room? Oh, this is not where I meant to go. I mean, I know that this...
it's shimmering.
Yeah.
A light that doesn't seem real. As if it's just on the edge of existence.
Yeah, I know that this is... I know what that
is. It makes me think of something.
Yeah.
Something I saw earlier. Or maybe I read it.
Yeah. I know it's... I don't know if it's the tablet, but yeah, I know this is...
It won't accomplish anything. Can you look at this inscription, Maggie?
I know that it may... there's something invisible or something here.
Does it say anything that might help?
All right, well, walk closer so that I can give it to you, because that's how it works.
It wasn't clear to me before, but now I can see. Boston, it exactly describes that strange field of almost light.
What does it say?
It's a set of instructions. Now it makes perfect sense.
Go and press the buttons. We'll see what happens. Because I can't
just
remember
twist
what's
this.
Here.
Everything's so simple when you read the directions.
Yeah.
If we didn't know better, we'd think that island had been there for a million years.
Maybe it had. Alright, well, let's go out to the island. Beach Island. Amazing.
This island was brought back from another dimension.
Yeah, I know. Oh, opening. There's a way down. Ah, this is where we get the last of the pieces from. Uh-huh.
What was so important that they left us exact instructions on how to get here?
The
maybe that metal plate.
Exactly, the floating metal plate. Examine plate.
Looks like one of the control plates we found on Attila.
Yeah, that's what you say about all of them, in that exact inflection.
That's the fourth one.
Yep.
If it's like the metal plates on Attila, these four should fit together in that triangle matrix.
Yes, but there's no guarantee that putting them together will take us anywhere we want to go.
Meh.
You have the most cheerful thoughts, Ms. Robbins.
If you had been abducted by a monster and then half drowned, you might be pessimistic too.
But you were only half drowned. Yeah.
And your hair looks terrific again.
You sure know how to make a girl feel good.
We better go find Brink again.
Really?
In case these metal plates do the job.
He threatened to kill me the last time I saw him. Maybe it would be safer if we leave him and send an expedition back to get him later.
He threatened to kill you when smashed me in the face.
There's no guarantee we'll ever get back. For all we know, this is a one-way trip.
You're right. We can't leave him.
Yeah, we can.
He scares me, Boston. Worse than the monster.
They're both just hungry for something.
But Brink is smarter, more dangerous.
We're smart, too. Let's go.
To the door. To the opening. To, you know what, let's go to the tram. Oh, it's this one, which blocks all the view, yes. I mean, I wonder if it says, we're going this way because I want to try and put the fourth one in there and see what it says. Well, it'd say, no, we can't do that without Brink. Or, I mean, because it looks like it's just going to open a door. No. Oh.
That was a powerful one.
Commander Low, can you hear me?
Brink, we're looking for you. We've got the last of the metal plates and we...
Listen to me, Commander. I'm trapped. I need your help.
Where are you?
It's near one of the light bridges. An arched bridge over a waterfall, and then into a crevice in the rock. You must have been there. You're the one who's been turning on all the light bridges, aren't you?
Yeah.
Hold tight. We're on our way.
Hold tight? Very funny.
Yeah, I remember this bit. But, you know, we're still going to the Nexus to try and put the plate in the thing. You just wait, alright? We don't care about you, Brink. I mean, you already died on the mission. Right.
We better go find Brink again.
Alright, okay.
In case these metal plates do the job.
All right.
He threatened to kill me the last time I saw him.
Blah, blah, blah.
Maybe it would be safer if we leave
him. Oh, I can press escape, can't I? Yeah. Hey, let's not hear that same conversation. Can you stay there, Mimi? No, I said you stay over there, Megagi. Now I have to wait for you to walk all the way over there. The camera will set slowly pan. I really chose the wrong one here, didn't I? I wonder if there's only one ball, or if there are multiple balls. I mean, one ball would make it safer. But multiple balls would mean that more people could go places quicker. It would hate to be this, to be your daily commute, and there to be only one tram which took you to places. Yep, gotta make sure that that waterfall is working properly today. But, you know, I hate the commute in the morning because it takes me 5 hours to get there because everybody else is trying to do it at the same time. Spire. Plateau. Path. No, okay, this is where he was. Let's go and see. Has he finished his beautiful, beautiful machine? I mean, how would we even know? Is the real question. No. Alright, well, there we go. Onto the light bridge. And then, where are you, planetarium? There you are. Over the waterfall. Into a cave where there's a crevice. Here we are.
You've just got your hand jammed in the rock? I thought you were in real trouble, Brink.
When would it be real trouble, Commander? When it's your hand?
Probably.
I don't go sticking my hand into cracks.
I was reaching for a life crystal, and then the rock shifted. My circulation is cut off. No blood is getting to my hand. You can't pull me out, Commander. Don't leave me to die here, even if you have to cut off my hand.
Don't be so dramatic, Brink. Nobody's going to cut off your hand.
Guess what I'm about to do.
You might not be able to keep, Maggie.
Guess what I'm about to do.
He's just got a stuck hand.
It's a race to see whether gangrene kills him before he dies of thirst or starvation.
You'd cut it off.
Yeah.
Of course he would. The military trains you to recognize necessity and do it.
Also, I mean,
it would be easier if I had anything to cut it with.
You do.
Chew it off then.
No.
Oh, I would, Brink. But human teeth can't bite through bone.
After all that's happened to us, this may be the most horrible.
Do something, Commander. Do it now.
Yep. I mean, I could kill you. And then, you know, chop your hand off and then revive you so that you didn't feel any pain when it was happening. I mean, I guess you'd feel the experience of the pain of death. But, you know, maybe that is better. Look what this jawbone is for. Let's look at it.
Whatever creature these bones used to be, I don't think we've got anything like it on Earth.
You're not going to say they're really sharp or anything, because, you know, that would be a great hint. I remember spending hours trying to work out, well, not hours, but a while trying to work out how to do this. Hello.
You're going to saw off his hand with a jawbone?
Meh.
The teeth are razor sharp.
See, that would have been a nice line to have in there. In
do
the
it,
description,
Commander.
So that you know what's going on. Ow! They're razor sharp. I bet they could cut through bone.
Brace yourself, Brink.
I bet they could cut through just about anything. What kind of a creature needs teeth like this?
I can't believe you endured so much pain without fainting.
I'm fine. But I'll need more crystals.
Come with us to the Triangle Matrix. We've got all the metal plates. We think it's gonna take us home.
You don't know where it's going to take you.
True.
I'd rather gather more life crystals.
What if it does take us home, Brink? What if we can't come back and get you? Do you want to stay here forever? Then what will happen to your research into the life crystals?
Yes, I see your point. I'll go with you to try out these metal plates. But if it doesn't get us home, then you two will stop interfering with me from then on.
Meh.
All right? You agree we have a deal?
Agreed.
All right, all right.
Oh, wait, just knock him out like he punched you. You can punch him back. He's got no hand now. Or he's got one less hand. And he's not yet acclimatized to how to use it. So, you know. And why do you all think this is gonna do it? There's clearly a door next to it. I mean, I suppose we're on an alien planet, so nothing should be taken to mean like what it would be on Earth. But, you know. Oh, they're doing a thing!
That should do it.
Do what? What's happening?
Nothing is happening, that's what.
Woo! Doorway opened.
That's not exactly nothing, Brink.
It's a door.
To a spaceship?
You think Earth is on the other side? I think nothing is on the other side.
What did you expect? The Tooth Fairy to come and fly us all home?
Yes, because that is what you were telling us would happen.
Let's see what's in there.
We had a deal. I came, these metal plates did not take us home, and now you will have to leave me alone forever. You gave me your word, and I expect you to keep it.
All right.
He is definitely insane.
Is that your opinion as a journalist?
It's my opinion as a sane person.
All right, well, let us go look in the open door. Oh no, that tram button is red. That means the tram doesn't work here. No, it does work. It's just red. Alright, come with me, my gaggy. Through the door to this exciting new place.
I saw something like this in the museum display.
Did you?
This machine was the greatest of the inventor's achievements.
What does it do?
I haven't the faintest idea.
Does it make life crystals?
You think it might send us home?
Right now it's doing nothing.
Alright, we've got a console. Let's randomly push buttons. And then we've got another console. Do we need to be using two consoles at once? Oh, we got strange objects as well.
It looks like there's a part missing here.
Yeah, alright.
There's a gap.
Yep. It looks like we can't do anything yet. What about if we look at this strange object up here? Or this strange object. Let's look at this one as it's closer.
An experiment?
I mean, we waited all that time for that exciting revelation.
A party favor?
No.
A party favor?
Alright, so one of them is an experiment, one of them is a party favor. We understand now.
It's a row of crystalline devices.
Cool.
It's a row of crystalline devices.
Alright, well, can we go out? No, but we can go up. Oh, look, there's another exchange object. If it's not a experiment or a party favor, what is this? Oh, wait, that's got controls.
I don't know how to work these controls.
Neither do I. But, you know, I point and click my way through most things.
It's almost hypnotic. Part of the machine?
No, obviously not. It's something weird and different, and obviously not part of the machine at all.
I don't know what to do with this device.
Meh, just start hitting buttons. Alright, go outside then. A seagull? Man, they get everywhere, don't they? There we go. Ah, oh, there's a nest. And a strange device. Alright, well, let's clean the nest.
Sorry, bird. You'll have to find a new home.
Yay! Do you work now? You do! That's all you had to do, clean off the nest. Other ones needed alignment and all kinds of things, but this one just needed a light bridge. Alright, well, let's go to the crystal form. Hey, Megagi, this is the crystal form.
I can almost feel the surface.
Good. Do you like it?
Robins.
Ooh. Alien device.
I've got to try and turn on the inventor's machine. It's the only way to find out what it does.
I mean, let's go and talk to the alien.
What do we do? Search all these islands for a part when we don't even know what it looks like?
Exactly.
Where are all those helpful hints now?
The hints were about things they deliberately hid to keep them safe. But this missing part, what if it was stolen? Or just corroded away?
Then all of this would be for nothing. Boston, somebody knows what the missing part does, and maybe even where it is.
I mean, I wonder who that could be.
I wasn't talking about you. I was talking about somebody who was sealed in a crystal pyramid.
Yep. You'll go there. But there's an island.
If I hadn't noticed that inscription and taken it with me, we could have wandered around here until we died without ever finding that island.
I mean, what if you didn't bring the shovel? Same things.
They hide it. Then they help us find it. Who can understand why aliens do what they do? Maybe it's a test of our intelligence.
Other aliens can't. Others of the same species.
Maybe it's a test of our dumb luck.
Or our persistence.
Ugh. Excuse me.
Thanks.
All right. Let's go out. And then we go to Tomb. Edge. Tomb. Crypt. And then we go through the door again to talk to the creature. This time I want to see this. I was going to say, just to see if Maggie is there as well. And she is. Because I thought it was an animated scene, not a, not a one with the character sprites on there. To the pyramid. To... where are you? There you are. The engraved rod.
It won't do anything.
Oh, sorry. Not the alien corpse. No, not the alien corpse. Panel. There we go. Finally found the right spot. Pixel hunting indeed. Then there was life crystals. Right, you.
Speak.
We found your machine.
The machine in your laboratory, what does it do?
Where the lights all shine, it opens the eye.
Aha! So the crystal thing where the light bridges all converge.
The eye. Does that mean the crystal at the meeting place of the light bridges? The machine generated this eye.
The eye sees into all space and time. And where the eye sees, the mind can fly.
Was this eye the doorway into the place where your people went?
A door that can be crossed only one way.
You don't know that.
Yeah.
If someone has a strong enough tie to reality...
You think you are stronger than all my people?
Why not? We're a different species entirely.
The strongest race known could not overcome the temptation before it was too late.
I don't care about
if we bring
whatever
your people
you've
back
got over
to this
there.
World, then
I
they
care
can
about
the Starship to take us home to Earth. It's our only chance. Maybe we'll fail, but you must let us try.
Since you think you are stronger and wiser than my people, I will let you have the fruit of your pride. I will tell you how to find the piece I hid, if you know how to ask. But it will cost you more than you ever imagined.
That doesn't sound ominous at all.
The island we found, where was it hidden?
It left this reality, but only a little way. It can come back, because it never fully left.
The island moves in and out of our reality?
It loses substance with every passage. We thought we could take our world with us into space-time 6. It could not be done.
Alright, so does that mean that everything is on there loses a little substance every time as well? So... you can't... so eventually the Nexus plate will...
When something leaves our reality,
away.
Where does it go?
To a place where time is infinite in all directions. But because it does not move along a single line, it can never be predicted or controlled. Those who go there from here cannot change anything. They are nothing but observers. Forever.
Mm. Alright, okay, let's ask about the wedge.
Please, don't play any more games with us. Where is the missing piece?
You cannot understand what will begin if you activate the eye.
Eh.
You cannot bear to pay what it will cost you.
Yes, you've warned us. Now where is the piece?
Go to the map with this message and see what it shows you.
Aha! You will have another icon, thank you. Cool. And now die! I can kill you
Help
with but a word.
By giving up. Never look into the impossible eye. You don't have the strength to return from that place.
Yes, I do. Because as I said, I like nachos. Alright, what have we got on the engraving? Green cube. Green, blue, green, red. Okay. Now let's go to the map place. As fast as we can. Oh, my gaggy. Hurry up. Yes, in case you're wondering, I can't say Maggie correctly. Why am I saying Maggie? Why, that's for me to know and for me to tell you. Oh, not Lens, Lightbridge. No wonder you weren't going there quickly. Map. It's because of the Simpsons when they were making birthday cake for her. No! That's not the right birthday cake, Homer. This is the one that you can use and spoil. And it said, Happy Birthday Magagi on it. For some reason, that has always just stuck in my mind. Right. Green, blue. Oh my god, why can I not remember this simple thing? And then red. Red Squidge as well. There we go. Now we see... You better say something, Boston, because I'm not sure.
So that's where the part is.
Assuming he gave us the right code.
Where was that? Show me that again? I'm not sure where it was. Alright, here we have a place. Is it a beach? Is that the beach? I don't know.
So that's where the part is.
Am I gonna have to visit everywhere?
The right code.
Oh, dang, there's a spider in the background there. Did you see it?
This place is as creepy as the forest behind my house when I was a kid.
I don't think we need to see the spider again. I can't remember. Yeah, it's the beach. It was here. All right, what do we do now?
Robbins. Do you get the idea that he really doesn't want us to succeed in repairing his machine?
Let's just find the missing piece.
Yeah, Bye. We're here. Do I need to hunt over everything for it? Ah! Aha! There it is. The answer is yes, he does want us to hunt over everything. Whee!
I wish I knew what's going to happen when I get this piece back in place.
No, you don't. You're just gonna go and do the thing anyway. I mean, you'll try pretty much anything to get home, right? Because you want to get home? Cathedral, is that what we're calling it? Okay. Lab. So why isn't it called Lab Spire? Why is it Cathedral? Because it's not a cathedral. Round and round we walk, without me needing to press any buttons. There we go. Gonna put the eye in. Let's see what happens. Oh! Hey there, Brink. What are you doing here?
Where have you been?
Where have we been?
I need your crystals. All of them. Right now!
Come on, Brink. How many crystals can one man use?
All of them.
Not for me, you fools. I need them for my machine. For science. Research. Give them to me!
Machine? What are you talking about?
I'm through talking! I'm not going to let anybody stand between me and the greatest scientific achievement in history!
I thought you're too high on your own products.
I only have these few crystals left, Brink, but I'll be glad to share some of them if you want.
All of them! You didn't share anything, Lo. I took them! And it's a good thing you didn't fight me.
Why?
I would have killed you to get these.
Eh.
You would have tried.
You two will be nothing but a footnote in the annals of my achievements.
He didn't damage the machine part, did he?
He wasn't interested in the slightest. But now I have the eye part. Well, actually, let's examine the eye part, eh?
This must be the part for the eye machine.
This must be the part for the eye machine. What are you talking about? What eye machine? Is it gonna... I guess it sees the eye and does most time things, but you know.
But the machine still doesn't work.
It needs life crystals.
Did the alien lie to us?
Look.
Or does the machine need something else?
Look at the spots beside it.
Looks like a life crystal would fit perfectly in here.
Yep.
Looks like a life crystal would fit perfectly in here.
I mean, let's go find... What's his face, actually? Alright, let's go the slow way, all the way up. We can't talk to the alien, because the alien needs to be revived with a life crystal, and we don't have any life crystals. So, you know... Maybe I should have talked to Mimagagi before we did this, just in case she went, nah, I was keeping life crystals in my pockets. Hey, Robbins.
Robbins.
Ah.
Do you think we should try this part in the eye?
We did.
I get the feeling the inventor didn't want us to do this.
We already did that.
Of course we should. It's probably our only chance of getting home.
We've got to try and turn on the inventor's machine. It's the only way to find out what it does.
Indeed.
Well, we've got the part.
All right, well. You were in the tomb spire, weren't you? You were over here, right? We're gonna see what the tomb does. We need two life crystals. We know where there's one. We know there's one where your hand
get
is there.
Get away from here! I won't let you break my life crystal machine!
Huh?
We don't want to break anything.
My machine isn't working yet.
Yes, gloat if you want to. I've studied all the inscriptions. Maggie's not the only one who can decipher strange languages. I followed the plans I found, but there's still something missing, and without it, the machine won't work.
Uh-oh,
if you think you can steal my life crystals again, Commander Low, think again. I'll kill you first, and believe me, no one will ever revive you.
I don't think I want to be revived.
Actually, you robbed me twice, and I only robbed you once. So you're still one ahead.
Don't joke with me!
I mean...
Don't joke with him, Boston.
Yeah. Alright.
What are you doing here? I have no need for your help.
No, I was going to look around, actually. Oh, where can we get life crystals from there, Robbins?
Robbins.
Do you know where there are life crystals?
After seeing what they've done to Brink, we'd better think long and hard before we start duplicating these back on Earth.
Don't worry. We're probably never going back there. And even if we do, I doubt anyone will ever be able to figure out this alien science.
Nope.
Thanks.
Alright, well, we know where there were a bunch of life crystals, so let's go have a look there in the museum. They were all down here, in this room. No, empty crystal repository!
They're all gone.
We could go back to the planetarium, because we know, as we said, we know where there's one with his hand. Let's look in the crevice.
Yeah, right. Like I'm gonna stick my hand in some crack in the rock on an alien planet.
Yep. Only an idiot would do that. So let's not go there. We know there was some with the guard aliens on the tomb. I can't remember where we get them from. I'm trying desperately to remember. We obviously can't talk to... can't talk to them. Yeah, there were some in here which brought up the things. I don't know if we can do anything with the slot. I can't remember.
A life crystal fell from this slot and resurrected that guardian creature.
Yep. Does that mean we can stick something in there to get life crystals out of there?
That could be a really bad idea.
I mean, it could be. Oh yeah, I suppose if you stick the tusk in there and an alien goop gets on it and it resurrects the whole creature while you're holding the tusk, that would be a bad thing to have happen. Robbins, do you know where we can get some life crystals from? I don't think you can, because you're just going to say the same thing about the...
After seeing what they've done exactly at Brink, we'd better think hard before we start duplicating these back on Earth.
Don't worry. We're probably never going back there. And even if we do, I doubt anyone will ever be able to figure out this alien science.
I mean, maybe.
Thanks.
I mean, we need life crystals for the machine. His machine isn't working. Perhaps his machine needs the eye as well? I don't know. Can't recall. Can we take the thing out again? Is the question. Is there a spot that I have missed to click on? Because it is, you know, like, hey, you can walk over here. Except I didn't move the cursor far enough along, like I did with the missing the other place. All right. Alien device.
I don't know what to do with this device.
No, I know. Just push the buttons randomly. That'll work. Right?
I don't know how to work these controls.
No, always complaining about not being able to do things. Okay, well, in which case, go further down. Just keep walking down, go to the console.
I guess I'll take this with me.
Right. Because I have a feeling that it needs to go into What's-His-Face's machine. Ooh. Outside. I seem to recall that is what happens to it. Back to the tomb, which I can never remember where it is on the map. Hey!
Go away! My work is very important. You can't possibly understand what I'm doing here.
Eh. I mean, I've got something of yours for you. Oh, maybe I should have used the item on you rather than... Right, there we go. No, I can't talk to you about
it. I think I know what piece is missing from your machine.
How can you know anything about this? You're not a scientist. You're just a strutting tin soldier.
I think it's the same piece that the eye generator needed. I think it's the key to all this technology.
I mean, I don't know how we know that, but all right.
Because without it, none of the machines he considers dangerous will work.
Why would the creator of life crystals think they were dangerous?
Because the crystals make you feel so good that they take over your life. All you care about is getting more of them. He said it was the second worst mistake he'd made.
And the worst mistake?
Life crystals. No?
So you and Maggie, you keep telling me I'm crazy. But you plan to make an even worse mistake.
I'll make you a deal, Brink.
Yes, like the deal you made before. I keep my part, but you go back on it.
I didn't go back on it. I just wanted to talk about it with you first.
We no deals left. With liars and thieves.
We haven't left him alone forever.
Brink, you need what I have to make your machine work. But if it works, then you'll have plenty of life crystals, right? You could share them with us and it wouldn't cost you anything, right?
If you have the missing parts, yes.
That's my deal. Your machine, my part. 50-50 on the life crystals.
I know you plan to cheat me.
We won't even come near the machine when it's running. You divide up the life crystals.
Then what's to stop me from keeping them all?
Because I am trained as a military man, Brink. And if I ever actually decide to fight you, I don't care how strong and healthy you are. You will lose. And then I will take them all. Got it?
Oh, wow, there we go.
Get
that's
your
a threat.
Missing part and put it in my machine. Even liars and thieves can bargain as long as they watch each other very carefully.
You shouldn't have said 50-50. What you should have said is...
half the life crystals, Brink.
Two life crystals.
Remember?
And you can have the rest.
You hairless
because
monkey.
That's what we need. We, presumably. One for each side of the thing. Use eye part with relic.
I just don't know how yet to link them up.
What? Slot, right there. Alright, well, alright. I have to use it exactly with the slot, not the machine. There we go.
It fits perfectly. This is how the aliens designed the life crystal machine to work.
Nothing's happening.
Yes, it is. It's vibrating. Be patient.
Is it?
Who knows
okay.
how fast
well,
it's supposed to work? We'll just have to wait.
Suits me fine.
Oh, there we
split them 50-50, right?
Of course.
50-50.
50
Look,
for you.
There's one. And another.
Two.
Is that all? Just two? I need more than two.
I don't know about that, Brink, but it's a sure thing I need more than one. You still have all the crystals you stole from me and every other place on these islands.
Don't touch them!
50-50, you said, Brink. Well, you must have hundreds of life crystals.
That's not what
he...
Wow.
It's not even 50-50 if I take these two.
That's definitely not what he was talking about, but hey.
I knew you were a liar and a cheat.
Yeah, exactly.
You weren't gonna let me have even one of these.
I'll make the machine even better. It will produce more.
Not till we're gone, it won't. I need that machine part to run the eye generator.
You will take nothing from this machine, you lying thief!
Once
not a thieving
liar,
working,
but a lying
come
thief.
Back with
okay.
us to Earth. Or you can stay here. Take the part out of the eye generator and put it back in your own machine. Just have a little patience.
Alright, well, we'll have the eye part, thanks. Completed
no.
machine, is it?
My machine is stopping! You've wrecked my machine! You're
you took the battery out.
Man.
I don't know that that makes
Brink,
it break.
Please. We don't have to fight. You can have the part back after we're done with it.
Everything you say is a lie!
Maggie, tell him.
This statement is true.
If you say a word, Maggie, I'll kill you too!
Brink, don't make me hurt you.
You won't hurt me when you're dead!
And this is how...
Brink!
The best death ever!
Please believe me, I didn't want to hurt him. I didn't
you
want
didn't
to
hurt him. At all.
It wasn't Brink who died here. Brink died when he fell down the hole when we first arrived. What just fell over the cliff was someone else.
Yeah.
Someone alien. Created by those death crystals.
No, Maybe you named them.
Even worse mistake. By activating the eye.
Staying in this world any longer than we have to, that's the worst mistake we could make. We've got to do anything we can to survive.
But what if we die trying?
Well, then we die trying.
Get it, Boston? This place is worse than death. I'd rather die than stay here.
Okay, alright. Let's have a look down, though. See if we can see his body. Nope. Okay. And I guess we just leave him at the bottom of the chasm. Or not, not chasm, at the bottom of whatever this is. We go to the lab spire, because I refuse to call it the cathedral spire. Insert the eyes, insert the crystals. We got the crystals, right? Yeah, we got two. We didn't even bother to search for the other ones. I mean, I didn't bother to search for the other ones, I should say. Because I'm sure Boston Lowe would have done so. Had he had, you know, free will to do so. Come on, keep going down. I clicked on the thing. No, okay, now you will. That's fine. Take your time, Boston. It's not like there's a deadline for you to get home or anything. I mean, it's not like you have limited supplies of food and water. I mean, you didn't even bring any MREs with you, because of course, I suppose you don't have limited supplies of food and water. There's a load of water around, which might or might not be drinkable. Possible? And then you could just resurrect things with...
The crystals Brink died for.
Yep. Alright, here we go.
Helium was right. This thing has already killed one of us. But it's back in place.
I mean, so did the spade, right? He was digging and he died. So, you know.
It's a row of crystalline devices.
Wait, is that not how the bit that we use? It says console. That also says console, though, to be fair. No, this says controls, though. Alright.
I don't know how to work these controls.
Okay. Where's Maggie? Does she know how to work these controls? It's humming and ready to go.
I don't know what to do with this device. All Robbins.
Right. Alien device.
You're the one who read the alien books.
Oh, we're gonna start at the bottom, alright.
What exactly happens when we turn it on with enough life crystals in it?
It would have taken me years to read everything, Boston. And I didn't understand half of what I read. But there's no doubt that this machine is dangerous. The alien warned us it might cost us more than we expected.
What does that mean?
It might mean that just turning on the machine might kill us.
You mean he booby-trapped the thing?
I mean that the machine may draw on more than life crystals. It may drain the life out of whoever uses it.
Then I'm running the controls.
Don't be absurd. It might do nothing, too. Or it could kill whoever isn't at the controls.
Yep.
I just want to tell you.
No goodbyes. We're gonna make it home together, Maggie.
I'm not sentimental, Boston. I wasn't going to say goodbye. I just want you to promise me something.
After you saw me break every promise I made to Brink, you want me to make another one to you?
What happened with Brink couldn't be helped, Boston. I know you'll keep your word with me.
What's the promise?
If I die, and you live, don't use any life crystals on me. Don't revive me. Do you understand?
Are you sure?
I saw what Brink became. I don't want that to happen to me. You wouldn't be saving Maggie Robbins. You'd be creating a monster with my memories, my face. Don't do it. Promise me.
I promise, Maggie. And vice versa, okay?
All right.
And now you tell me the truth about something, Maggie. Are you sure you didn't find out somewhere that something bad happens to the person at the controls of this machine?
Boston, I don't know any more than you do about what will happen when I switch this thing on.
If that's a lie, I'm gonna be really ticked off, Maggie.
Yeah, I know. Here we go!
There we go indeed. Look, it is a party favor.
Worth it then. Go home.
Maggie.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
Poor kind man.
I mean, I don't know how she, if she knew. I mean, that doesn't make any sense because it only happened because it got stuck. So, you know, there's a thing. I should say that there is a minor thing that we can do there. We can actually get one of the life crystals. I believe we get them out of the console again and use it on Maggie. And, you know, that is the only meaningful decision you can make in this, in a choice sort of way. Yeah? Oh, yes. I forgot about that. We'll wait here. And yeah, she will come back, and it will change the engine.
I should have
the
known
ending,
the inventor would have
engine,
one more trick
slightly
up his sleeve.
I don't know that the inventor did that. Maybe it did. All right, I know how to do this. I remember this because I had loads of fun doing this when I was a kid. Just you push the button, and it turns off the thing. And I don't mean loads of fun doing that. What I mean is what I will show you next.
That was the inventor's last chance to stop me. I will get out into space-time 6. I will bring the people of this place back home, and they will build me a starship that will take me back to Earth.
Yep. What I mean is this. Look, the lights, the line, and then you can just stop the line. I don't know why that it pleased me inordinately to just be able to stop the line from forming when I was a kid. I don't know. Stupid simple thing. Now, the bridge is back. We cross the bridge. This is it. This is the eye. Into space-time 6. That's where we're going.
I guess this is the real test.
Yep, can you come back again?
Can a guy from Earth do what all the builders of this place failed to do?
I mean, you're different people.
Can I go into space-time 6 and still find my way back to reality? Only one way to find out.
Yep. Here we are. Oh.
It must be the portal into space-time 6.
Yeah, it looks like it. Ah!
It's beautiful.
But there are no nachos, so I'm going home.
No, I'm not going any farther into this place. I'm staying here, where I can get back out again.
You are as strong as we hoped, human.
I can understand you.
In space-time 6, all living minds communicate perfectly. You stand at the doorway.
show us. Look at all those people sort of weirdly swimming towards their ways back.
To reality. To a place where we will someday die, yes. But we will have a life before we die.
Scaring away that thing.
I can see them all, but which one is real?
Go back now, human. Take me home. My people have their bodies, their bones, their lives again.
Yep.
We owe you a great debt, Commander Lo.
All I want, now that my friends are dead, is to go back to Earth and tell the story of how they died.
Why not let them tell their own story?
I wish.
You
can you do that?
Home, but I know all the other paths through time and space.
But I mean...
Wait, don't go back there.
Does that mean I have to come in and get you again? No, look, it's the people.
I have brought you a gift.
Maggie. Brink. You're alive again.
Look at Brink,
though. We were lost, but this being found us and led us back.
Cheesy grin. You've got a hell of a story to tell about when you were dead.
I thought I'd lost you forever.
So you really didn't try to resurrect me with the crystals?
And that's about the only thing that changes.
I promised you.
Those couple
of
lines.
And besides, what the crystals bring back from death, it wouldn't have been you.
I know, Boston. You kept your word.
Yeah, I did.
And yet, you did find a way to bring me back from death.
It wasn't me, but I'm glad you're here.
And I'm free of the madness of the crystals, too.
You are looking rough, buddy.
You did it, Lo.
No, it was our friend here.
No, the credit belongs to you. We once revered a great inventor because he opened the door to unchanging eternity. But you opened the passageway back into true life.
All I am is a guy who wants to get back home.
Already my people are preparing a great crystal starship to take you there.
But we can come back, can't we?
You and any others who wish to come. You are a young people, strong and full of hope and passion. We have much to teach you, and you have much to share with us as well. There will be friendship between our species forever.
I hope you're right. Not all human beings are as, nice as us.
Oh, I know that. All young species are alike that way.
I should have saved just before the point where we had the choice, so that Magagi, we could see the ending where Magagi was revived.
We'll mash them like bugs.
How reassuring.
The ship is almost ready. Go home and tell your people what has been accomplished here.
They are fast builders.
That's Maggie's job.
And getting us home? That was yours. You did it, Boston.
Thank you, Boston.
We all thank
look at
you,
me.
Boston, no.
Thank you. Into the crystal ship. Sign of friendship and mutual respect, showing that we hold no weapons in our hands. I mean, but you might be able to just blast us with your mind for all we know, so that gesture might be meaningless. I wonder if it's going to drop them off at the exactly the same point as where they arrived. So, you know, it's going to deposit them in space and they're just going to die due to asphyxiation. There we go. Boston Scott Card. Oh, okay. That was him. Yes. That is the end of the dig. Wasn't that amazing? Okay. You're gonna hear various Windows noises as I do this. Yep, bet you loved hearing those. Ah, and that was the dig. And yes, it was still as enjoyable as I thought it was, as it was when I played it back in the day when it first came out. I don't think I got it when it first came out, actually. I think I got what was called a white box version, which was like a... They sold like the original stuff, and they went, wow, this is selling really well, so now we'll just make versions that are just the basics. There's no big like cover on it on the box, because it came in a big box that was far too big for the tiny manual and the CD that came in there, and the CD case. But yeah. And they were at a cheaper price, because wow, we've got a thing that is critically acclaimed or has sold well or whatever it was that made them change. So yeah. And it was fun. Just as much fun as it was today. So, 2 thumbs up from me. Although, obviously, there are bits in there that, you know, might have changed. Would be better with the newer technology and gaming language that we have. Other things that we would have to show how things combine, etc., to make hints, etc., easier to do. But yeah, a lot of fun as we sit here on this and know that Boston Lowe made it back to Earth, the only one who of his party who did not die. The only alien? No, I was going to say the only person on the planet who did not die. But no, there were a lot of other aliens, and we didn't kill off the spider monster. And you know, the spider monster never came back. There are as many as are needed, and they do all those tasks, and we made them, and they do things. But you know, they didn't come and try and stop us again. The only things we really killed were those two guards by the tomb. Yeah, they came and attacked us. Or they would have attacked us had we got close, and instead we made a second one appear. Ah, yeah. And there's a novel by Alan Dean Foster. I believe there's an audiobook version of it as well. I've never read it, so... Ghosts of Deeks Past. People who worked on there and... No, okay, Ron Gilbert. I don't think he worked on this. Maybe he did? Maybe these are just the names of people who have helped and inspired them to make this beautiful, beautiful game. Maybe they contributed like a little thing as they worked at LucasArts. Very special thanks to George Lucas and Steven Spielberg. I mean, it doesn't matter that Steven Spielberg had his name in the thing. And there we go. The end. Fade out into nothingness. I don't remember that. And yes, that was the dig. Oh, wasn't that fun? We spent like 2.5 hours doing this. That was good. But, you know, I would like to do some Jedi Survivor as well. So if you'll bear with me 1 second, I will say thank you very much for being here. The fact that you have spent any of your time here, whether you're here live and in person or later on in the VOD, means that you are appreciated by me for doing this. So yes, I'm going to stop the recording here and say thanks very much. I have been Richard, and this has been LMTDTMFFR, or say it with me now, Limited Time Offer, No Vowels. Have fun. Stay weird.